Hello, good day to everyone. Today let's see how to install an emergency stop switch to an electrical load. Although a stop push button is available on an operating panel, conveyor belt or complex machinery requires an easy to operate and easily accessible stop push button to prevent a dangerous situation immediately. Therefore, one or more emergency stop push buttons are a must near the operator and the nearest supervisor when operating fairly hazardous equipment. The push button knob should be in red and the background yellow for easy identification of it in an emergency. When pressed, it will be locked in stop position, so you cannot start the equipment back until you reset it by turning the knob on clockwise direction. For installation work, we have a three-phase line here, and an induction motor for the electrical load. We require a three-pole breaker, miniature circuit breaker and a magnetic contactor with a thermal overload relay intact. Let's insert the emergency shutdown button here. The one we got here has two sets of normally closed contacts, and one set of normally open contacts. We can fix the emergency stop button in a convenient position, where the operator can easily access it to stop the machine in an emergency. For the motor, a start push button and the indication lamp, and a stop push button and the corresponding indication are required. An additional indication is given to identify the motor overload condition. Illuminated indication for emergency shutdown is also provided here on the panel board. First, three-phase line is connected to the motor through the breaker and the magnetic contactor. One-phase line is taken for the single-phase motor control circuit and passed through the breaker switch to the NC contact point of the emergency stop push button switch. The control line must always pass through the normally closed contact points of the emergency stop switch, and the normally open terminals can only be used to connect a buzzer or an indicator lamp. Other end is connected to the terminal 95 of the NC contact points to break the control circuit when motor is overloaded. From terminal 96, line goes through the normally closed stop push button switch and the normally open start push button switch to the A1 coil end of the magnetic contactor. Connect the neutral line to the A2 end of the contactor. The contactor's holding circuit begins between the two push button switches and passes through the normally open contact points of the contactor before joining A1. This circuit will hold the contactor in its on position when you release the start button after pushing it in to start the motor. For motor running indication, connect the lamp to A1 and also to the neutral line. For motor stop indication, connect the bottom terminals of NO and NC contacts together. Then connect the upper terminal of NC contact points and the neutral line to the lamp. For motor overload indication, connect the contact input terminals NC and NO, that is 95 and 97 together. Then connect terminal 98 and the neutral line to the lamp. To indicate emergency shutdown on the panel board, connect control line through the NO terminals of the emergency stop push button switch to the lamp. Connect the neutral line too. Now when you switch on the breakers, motor stop indicator lamp comes on. To operate the motor, push and let go the start button. Motor runs now with green indication lamp on. To stop the motor, push and let go the stop button. If the motor is overloaded during operation, it stops and the overload lamp lights. During operation, if you want to stop the machine urgently, simply reach for the nearest visible emergency stop button and press it. Motor stops, and the emergency stop push button is now locked in its stop position. No one can restart the machine now until the system is reset by turning the emergency stop button clockwise. I hope you now have a good understanding of the emergency stop requirement of a machine and how the switch works. If this video is useful, please subscribe to the channel. Thank you.